Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Rosa Technocrat. Today we will be talking about troubleshooting an interface or troubleshooting the drop issues. So troubleshooting an interface is generally all about the status of an interface, whether there are drops on the interface, whether there are duplex issues, auto negotiation issues, CRC errors, or any layer one issues. Okay, so let's start. So the important commands when we are troubleshooting interface are these ones. So if you know all these commands, that will be enough to know what might be causing a interface to be flapped or a interface to be going down, or if there are any packet drop issues. So the first command is get system interface physical. So this command basically tells you about what is the current physical status of the interface. Maybe it's up and down, what is the speed and negotiation, that's it. So it's just gives a summary of the interface on a physical level. And then we have got diag net link interface list that gives more details than compared to the interface physical. And then the third one we have is diag hardware device info. So this command gives all the information whatever possible related to the interface. And these two commands are similar, like diag hardware device info nic, or you can do get hardware nic. So both these commands gives almost exactly the same output, so you can use any one of these. One difference is, like, this command works only in global mode if you have a multi VDOM environment, whereas netlink and get system interface works in particular VDOM. So the first command, as I told, like get system interface physical. So whenever you try to run get interface physical, you will see this as the output. So as you can see, I tried get system interface physical, and if I don't specify the port number here, it gives information about all the ports on the firewall. So for example, you can see here the management one interface, the IP addressing mode is static, this is IP address, then speed, duplex, and what is the negotiated value for the duplex and the speed. So same way it will list management one, two, and all additional interface. I'm just showing you as an example here. So now let's talk more into detail on the get system interface physical. So now if you specify a particular port number after physical, then it will give details only about that port. Like in the previous, if you see, it was showing all the interfaces. But here now you will be able to see only the port number which you are specifying here. So get system interface physical port 1. It will only give you details about the port 1. So what is the first one? The first one is tells you about, like, on the static or it's a DHCP interface. Then you have the status, which tells whether the port is up or down. Then we have got the speed, and the speed is, in my case, it's showing as any because the interface is down. So this tells us about the speed and duplex. Then coming to the next command, which is diag netlink interface list. So this is more deep rather than the physical. Here it gives all the counters related to the interface. So if you do a diag netlink interface list port 1, here you can see, like, what is the port number here. Then you can see type of family, the type of the interface, whether it's Ethernet, fiber, then index, what is the interface index in terms of the CLI. Then the MTO of the interface, and then you have all the statistics of the interface. So RxP, TxP, RxB, TxB, these are the stats of the interface. So I will explain each of these counters in detail and what does it mean. Similarly, RE is for receive errors and T is for transmit errors, TE. So this is stat is the overall statistics, if you can see. And then you have got RE and TER specifically related to receive errors and transmit errors. So I have explained here these counters. For example, when you see the stat in this line, So this state contains RxP, TxP, RxB, TxB, RxC, TxC, RxD and TxD. So what does it mean? So basically Rx stands for receive and Tx stands for transmit. And RxP means Rx packets and TxP means transmit packets. So Rx packets means how many packets have been received by this interface. So this is a counter in terms of number of packets that are received on this interface. And TxP is the number of packets transmitted via this interface. Similarly, the first two counters were related to the packets and the next two counter relates to the bytes. So it's basically the size or datagram size, and this is the number of packets that the data is transmitted. So number of packets will always be higher than compared to the bytes, because one packet size depends on the number of bytes into that, whereas the packet count will be just based on number of packets. Sorry. Then you have RxB bytes, as I told, transmit bytes. Then RxE. RxE stands for Rx errors. Like if there were any receive errors on the interface. Then you have got TxE, that means transmit error, same way. RxD, this is important. When you are troubleshooting any drop issues or you are suspecting the issue might be because the firewall is dropping some packets or dropping some traffic, so then you may need to have a check at this dropped packet, and you have to see a delta if you, because you might have some counters already existing. So you have to compare over a period of time, or let's say you may need to run this command a couple of times to see if these counters are increasing while you are troubleshooting or while the issue is going on. The MC counter stands for the multicast, like how many packets are being part of multicast, and collisions if there are any collisions on the interface. So these states, all the counters are explained here. So now it may be easier for you to understand what is RxP, TxP. So generally we know the commands, but we don't know what are these values for, or what does this word or the abbreviation means. So that's why I'm explaining these variables here. So now coming to the second line, which is RE. So RE is basically receive errors. So I will explain all of these. You can see this one I have already explained, like RxP, TxP. So these counters I have explained. Same way now, RE, as I told, it's received errors, and T is transmitted errors. So any errors related to the receive of a packet or data, these values will increase if there are some errors. So in case of like any physical issues, layer 1 issues, maybe SAP issues, fiber cable issue, or any other physical issues, so you will see these CRC errors increasing, frame errors increasing, or maybe if it is something related to the queue on the interface, then it will be like RxFIFO errors and missed errors. If the firewall is busy or the CPU is highly being utilized, so then you may see these missed errors. So similarly, on the transmitted side also, you will have TxA, which is TX transmitted aborted errors, TX carrier errors, TX FIFO errors, and TX heartbeat errors, and TX window errors. Why we are not seeing the CRC or frame error on the transmitted? Because this is transmitted via the firewall from the interface. So the physical part does not come into the picture as it is being transmitted and it's getting out of the firewall. So physical layer will only come into the picture once it is out from this. So that's why you don't see the CRC errors under the transmit. But as a overall, you can see the CRC errors on the receive side. So this will, if you see any CRC errors or frame errors on an interface, that means the issue is related to physical cable, physical layer 1 issues. Okay, now coming to the third command, which is fnsysctl ifconfig. So ifconfig is generally a Linux command, and this is available on FortiGate as well. The only thing you need to do is, before this command, you have to put fnsysctl. So fnsysctl is generally like telling this is not a FortiOS command, but it's a Linux based command. And Linux based command can be executed on FortiGate by using fnsysctl. So if you do fnsysctl and ifconfig, it lists out all the interfaces that are available on the FortiGate, and it gives similar details like we saw earlier. like what is the hardware address or MAC address, the IP address, the broadcast address. And then similarly to the earlier command, we have got RX packets, TX packets, and any errors, dropped or overruns that similar to this you see on other network devices also, like any switches, Cisco switches or any other device. So there also you will be able to see such kind of counters. So everyone is well aware about layer 2 or switch like CRCs. Same is available here in this also, and even by using the previous command which we used in the previous command, which was like a diagnet link interface list port 1. So coming back, so if you are just putting fnccTL ifconfig, it lists out all the interfaces along with the counters. And if you specify a port number after ifconfig, then it will only show you the details for that particular port number. So as you can see, I have tried fnccTL ifconfig and the port number, so it will only list out that particular port number. Now coming to the last or the third command, which is the DIAG hardware device info NIC, and this is one of the most important command, or like the command which gives all the status of a physical interface. So if you are not using the other two, the first and the second command which I told, that is fn ifconfig and get system status physical, then this you have to use. In any case, you have to use, because this combines all the information from the earlier ones and gives a and provides a more detailed information about the interface. As you can see, I have tried one particular port number, and it shows description like what kind of the adapter is this, what is the driver name for this, the interface name, and then we have the serial number, major, OID, everything is given here. What is the current hardware MAC address and the permanent. So as you know, in FortiGate we have virtual MAC addresses assigned. So current hardware MAC address is basically the virtual one, and permanent hardware is the permanent MAC address of the interface. Then we have got the physical name of the interface, physical address, switch port, everything, all the details are given. And then this is related to the link status of the interface. So that is basically the admin status of the interface, that is whether the interface is up or down. Then we have got auto negotiation is configured, what is the link setting configured, link speed currently configured, current link status, speed and duplex it's not showing because it's not negotiated and the interface is down. Any local fault or any local warnings that are observed on the interface, any remote fault that is seen on this interface. So this all is shown under the link status, and it's part of the same command, but I have divided it into different screens or different pictures, because if I put it them into one picture, then that may not be clearly visible. Then there is further information in the same command, that is the counters. So these counters are the important counters, and more counters rather than the previous commands or ifconfig counters or the physical status counter. Here it gives or gives it provides a breakdown of these counters based on the CPU, based on the interface level, or based on the NP. So you might be aware, like FortiGates are having some NPs. And then they have got CPUs and the interface buffers. So this command provides counters from each level, like from the interface level, from the NP level, or from the CPU level, the host. So if you look here, the first counters, like where you only see RX, TX, like this black one or the gray highlighted. So these counters are corresponding to the like NIC itself, like on the port level itself. So these all counters are related to the NIC itself, and it gives us a picture like if the packets are being dropped at the NIC level itself without going further into the CPU or the integrated switch ISF, switch fabric, or going to the host. Then we have host RX counters. So host RX counters are like when the packets are being dropped by the CPU. So basically what happens after the NIC, the traffic goes to the CPU, and if the CPU is dropping these packets, then these counters will be increasing. So if you know host RX packets are increasing, that means there is something to do with the CPU as well. And then we have got these counters, which are like switch TX and RX. So switch TX and RX is basically, these counters are dropped via integrated switch fabric. So if we talk about the architecture of the FortiGate, from the NIC, the traffic goes to ISF, and from the ISF, it goes to the host or the NP. So this command tells you exactly where the packet is being dropped, whether it is on the ISF, on the host, or on the NP. And then the last ones, these counters, switch NP, these are for the NP, as I told. So if you see here, from this command or using DIAG hardware, we will come to know exactly where the packet is being dropped, and it helps us to figure out what might cause this and to dig deep into the actual cause, why it might be happening. So as I was explaining this counter, so I just tried to correlate with an architecture of a FortiGate. So the architecture may be different depending on different hardware models, but as a summary, so these first counters are the red ones. So basically this traffic is being dropped at the interface itself here, and then from interface the traffic goes to an integrated switch fabric. So whenever the packets are being dropped at the integrated switch fabric, these counters are being increased, switch RX and switch TX, these packets are getting increased, as I am showing here by the blue line. And host RX TX are the packets which are being dropped at the CPU level. You can see here, I am pointing it again back to an arrow to the CPU. So this is like these counters represent or tells us about whether these packets are being dropped at the CPU level. And then the last one, we have got the NP. So if the packets are being dropped at the NP level, it is being dropped here. So whenever we are troubleshooting interface issues, this command helps us a lot. Not a lot, but actually this is the command which we have to use for troubleshooting any drop or interface issues mainly. And let's say if you are not clear, or if you are not sure, like these counters are increased just now or they were earlier. So before starting troubleshooting or after the troubleshooting, you can just clear these counters and then do a fresh check on these counters. So if you want to clear the counters, you can use diagnose netlink interface clear and then the port number. So when one is just a port number, and you can use any port number which you want to clear the counters. Hope this gives you more information and this helps you further in your troubleshooting the interface issues. Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye bye. And I had used some of these references to prepare this PPT, and if you can visit these links as well, that will give you more detail about the same topic which we discussed. Hope this will help, and this you may use in your interface troubleshooting issues. Thank you everyone, and if you liked this video, please do subscribe and like my channel. Thank you for the support, guys. Thank you so much. Bye bye.